So Nita says, hey Pat, I have a question about what tricks do these SEO agencies apply that make them to rank their clients' sites and build so many backlinks? Yeah, I mean, this question would be answered completely differently if it was 3 years ago, right? Back when there were a lot of private link networks, there were a lot of sort of just existing websites with high authority that they had access to that they could link to just sort of gamify the system. Now, and this is a great thing, Google has sort of penalized things that like that and are looking and are more sophisticated to really show the best content up top for relevant searches that people have in Google. Tricks, I mean, they're good SEO agencies aren't using quote-unquote tricks. They're just using best practices. And best practices being, well, how might we be able to create content and formalize this content, obviously with the basics involved with, you know, H1s, H2s, H3s in your content structured the way they should be, keywords being targeted, data metadata being the way it should be, optimizing for speed, optimizing for just usability, optimizing for, well, how long can we keep a person on this page and then keep them going through, optimizing for shareability. And this really all stems down to, are you creating good content that's good enough and worth linking to? And really, you don't need an SEO agency to be able to do that, obviously. They can help and help guide you. But I think the biggest thing that we need to focus on is just writing or coming up with content that is actually worth being shared. And this is the big hard struggle, right? So it's one thing to just see a topic that's popular on another website and just kind of write your own version of that. It's another thing to really go further and beyond what most people are talking about in a way where it gets out there. It becomes, you know, something that's share-worthy, newsworthy. And that's the big struggle. So also there are studies being done right now on, you know, length of posts, and typically and more generally speaking, the longer posts that have more value in them are getting shared more and ranking higher. And I think it really depends on what keywords you're targeting as well, because I think different keywords have different opportunities too. It could be the also way that you reach out to other people and connect with them, build relationships with them in such a way that they know the kinds of things that you have to offer on your webpage and then can share those things too. For example, a lot of people have shared my podcasting guide, and it's been viewed, you know, over 1 million times. And that's because we went all out with structuring it in a way that makes it super easy to just from a bird's eye perspective, you know, work through the sort of process of starting a podcast, for example. And then what that does is it introduces people to that meaty piece of content in the way that I teach, and they want to go further with me and learn all the things in Power Up Podcasting. So I love what's being said here. Suzanne says, absolutely agree. Forget the tricks. Make quality content that serves people and you will eventually get noticed. Yeah, I think Neil Patel said that, right? Like, you know, write good things and the search engines will follow, right? Write good things and the search engines will follow.